Many people think that in order to become a hacker, they need to be an expert in Python, but that's actually not the truth. Hacking is the name of finding vulnerabilities and exploiting them, not becoming some high-end developer who develops programs and publishes them. But if that's the case, why did I title this video Python Basics for Hackers? Well, that's because instead of teaching you how to code, I'll show you a faster way of learning Python for the sole purpose of hacking, and explain how understanding just the basics can massively enhance your skills as a hacker. So let's get started.
Chapter number 1, the right way to learn Python.
Okay, so in the last video, I mentioned that before diving into hacking something, you first need to understand what it is, and how it operates, in order to naturally start seeing where its weak points might be, and how they can be exploited. Now if we apply this principle to a simple example, imagine one morning you open up your smart fridge to make breakfast, and suddenly wonder,
could someone hack this thing?
This thought becomes an obsession for the rest of the month, and you're now deep into researching how smart fridges actually work, and whether they can be used to infect your home network or not. After weeks of studying, you begin to understand the different technologies used in the fridge, and start identifying potential vulnerabilities. But there's a problem. When you go to GitHub to find a hacking tool for that specific vulnerability, there's nothing to use. No tool does exactly what you want in the exact way you need. So what do you do? Well, that's where Python comes in. You realize you need to program your own tool to exploit that vulnerability in the exact way you want. But do you need to learn programming from scratch? Well, the answer is no. You can simply tell ChatGPT the fridge model, what vulnerability you found, how you want it to be exploited, and ask it to generate a Python script for you. But here's the catch, what happens if the code doesn't work, or if you need to tweak it a little bit? Well, that's where you need to know Python just enough to understand the code, spot problems, and fix them. You don't need to master the entire language, but just learn the basics, and understand what variables are, what loops do, and how classes work. These fundamentals will give you enough knowledge to adjust the code as needed, or troubleshoot errors in most cases. And yes, if ChatGPT doesn't help you with writing certain scripts, you can always try another AI model to get an example code, and bring it back to ChatGPT to check for any errors, or help with multiple modifications. Now, to fully understand what your program is doing, you'll need to learn other technologies as well. For instance, if the vulnerability is in how your fridge connects to a network, you'll need some knowledge of networking, but that's separate from programming itself. For coding, all you need is a programmer's mindset, and even if you don't understand what a syntax does, or why a library is being used, you can always ask ChatGPT for an explanation. Another thing I want to point out is that while I used an example of smart fridge to explain the concept, in reality, you're more likely to use Python for other practical tasks. Most hackers use it not to develop their own tools, but rather automate different tasks to save time, and modify existing tools to avoid detection. So maybe you want to scrape data from Instagram, and instead of manually going through each post, you create a custom script to do it for you. Or let's say you find a Python-based brute-forcing script on GitHub, but it hasn't been updated and no longer works on the newer versions of Instagram. So instead of building a new tool from scratch, you can take that old one, provide it to ChatGPT, and modify it to get around Instagram's updated defenses. This way you'll stay efficient and learn on as you make progress.
Chapter number 2, but where to learn the basics?
Okay, so now that you know how to approach learning Python, the question is, where to learn it from? Well, the answer is simple. You can start by watching a free course online. I personally like this one by the YouTube channel Programming with Mosh. However, if you're someone like me who prefers a more structured approach rather than watching videos, Code Academy is another great option. The reason behind recommending Code Academy is that their Python course covers exactly what you need to get started as a hacker, and takes you through the fundamentals up to classes, which is really all you need for most hacking purposes. Anyway guys, so that's it for the video. If you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments section down below, and I'll see you in the next one.